Hey guys, it's Nelly. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with a look that you see on my face, my eyes, right now. This look is actually inspired by a super talented artist on Instagram. Her name is Stacy Marie MUA. I will leave her information, a picture of the look that I was inspired by on the screen, and I will have her information in the description box so that you can go and check her out. I had come across her Instagram page a little while ago, and I had saved this look because I wanted to do something inspired by her, and then I just kind of forgot about it, and then I saw Nikki Tutorials also recreated a look from her, and it just brought back memories. I'm like, oh my god, I have this look saved, and it's perfect now for the holiday season, so let me go ahead and give it a shot. This look has been a long time coming for many reasons. Reason number one, I took a picture of it and forgot about it. Reason number two, this is a look that I was trying to do with my Kylie palette. That was a complete and utter fail. And reason number three, this look has taken me a couple of tries to kind of get the technique down. I definitely do have to practice a little bit more. I don't think I have it quite yet, but yeah, I think it's beautiful. It's very different. It's a cut crease spotlight look, and yeah, I absolutely love it, and I think it's perfect now for the holiday season. I hope you guys enjoy. Please don't forget to subscribe and give the video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed. Hit the notification bell just to get updates whenever I upload. Sorry if I'm a little but it's really late. It's 9:12. I started filming this like at 6:30, and like I said, it took me forever to get it right, or somewhat right. If you want to see how to get this look, then just keep on watching.
Alrighty, you guys, let's get started. So I am starting off by priming my eyelids, and I am taking the MAC Select Cover Up Concealer. I love this concealer because it's really thin, but it still covers a lot. So I'm just going to apply this all over the lid, dance a little bit, and then I'm going to go ahead and take some translucent powder and set it in place. For my first shade, I am taking Makeup Geek's Chickadee. This is a beautiful yellowy tone shadow, and this is going to be our transition shade. In the look, if you pay close attention, she does have a very yellowy kind of transition shade, so we're just going to go ahead and follow in her exact same footsteps. I'm using this with a blending brush, like a big fluffy blending brush, and I'm applying it all over the crease. I'm going to go in to the Morphe 3502 palette, and I am taking those two fiery red shades, and I'm going to mix them together, and I am going to apply them to my crease. Don't get scared. I promise you it will come together. You want to make sure that you are packing this color really tight on that eye socket, like on that crease area. And once it's really nice and pigmented, you want to kind of go ahead and begin to move your brush to the side, like tilt it to the side, and start going into circular motions just so that that color begins to kind of blend upwards and it becomes nice and seamless. And then you want to go back in with a little bit more of Chickadee and just kind of blend out those edges to make sure that, again, the color is mesh together, mix, and that it looks nice and seamless. I'm going to go in with another Makeup Geek shade. This one is in Cherry Cola. Yay for Makeup Geek. It has been a while that I don't use them. And I'm going to take this with a Sigma E25. And I am first going to pack it in the outer corner and in the inner corner because that's where I want the color to be the most pigmented. So once I have it packed and ready to go, I am going to begin to just kind of blend the colors together and kind of connect them through the crease. So I'm kind of trying to create somewhat of a semi-circle, like a half circle on the crease. And then I'm just going to blend upwards. I thought I had heard someone, but it was no one. So I'm just going to, again, just start to blend upwards just to make sure that all of those colors kind of mesh together and mix and to have everything nice and seamless. But definitely spend some time packing in the inner and outer corner because that's where you want it to be the most pigmented. I'm going to go back in with that previous brush that has those fiery red shades. And I'm just going to blend again those edges and make sure that it's nice and seamless. Take a shot every time I say seamless. I feel like I've said it like 30 times already. I'm going to go ahead and take this eyeshadow by Makeup Forever. This is in the shade Eggplant 928. It's a beautiful, beautiful, super pigmented, rich creamy shade, purpley shade. And I'm just going to place this exactly in the same areas where we placed Cherry Cola. I just wanted something that was a little bit more purple and a little bit more pigmented and just more, a little bit more intense. So again, I'm just going to just place this in that same area, really blend it out and get it nice and pigmented. You want to go ahead and take a makeup wipe, wipe off any of the excess fallout, and let's get ready to cut that crease. So I'm going to go back in with the MAC Select Cover Up Concealer, and I am just going to start kind of carving out wherever you want that halo slash spotlight to be. And to be quite honest, this is kind of where I began to struggle a little bit, because she has like a really nice faded spotlight and it was still kind of shimmery. So I'm still kind of playing around with techniques to see how exactly I can achieve that look. But all you really want to do is just carve out that center part and just kind of move the concealer a little bit lower down to your lid. Her look was kind of purpley pink, so I am taking the Makeup Geek eyeshadow in the shade Black Light. It's a really nice iridescent kind of purpley pink shade. So I'm going to pack that wherever we applied that concealer on the center of the lid. And then I'm going to go in with another Makeup Geek pigment, and this one is in the shade Kaleidoscope. And again, I'm just going to pack this right in the center just to kind of mimic the same pinky purple bluish shade that she had. I think this pigment went perfect with the look. I'm going to go in with a pencil brush, and I'm going to go back in to that eggplant shade, that purpley shade, and I'm going to just kind of redefine the crease a little bit just so that we can really see that cut spotlight halo effect. So I'm just going to re-intensify that crease, and then to further add some shimmer, because I felt like the look wasn't shimmery enough. In her picture, her shimmer is like super intense and you can see it really well. So I went in with the e.l.f. Glitter Liner in the shade Pink Opal. It's such a beautiful, beautiful liner. It's gorgeous. So I packed that right on top. So I went ahead and I skipped over my foundation and my concealer routine because I do the same thing in every video. Nothing has changed. If you want to see how I do that, just watch one of my previous videos. So we're going straight into highlights. I am taking the Ofra Beverly Hills highlight shade. I'm taking the pink and the gold shade, and I'm going to mix them together. And I'm going to apply that to the tops of the cheekbones, down the chin, on the cupid's bow, up like right on that upper lip area. I'm also going to take with whatever is left on the brush, I'm going to apply some to the center of the forehead just to give me like an overall glowy look. And then I'm also going to just hit the tip of the nose and down the bridge of the nose as well, just to have a really nice overall glowy complexion. To bronze the skin, I am going in with the Bare Minerals Pro Contour palette. I'm taking that middle shade. I'm taking this big fan brush, and I'm just going to apply this again to the hollows of the cheeks, around the forehead, temple area, you know, just pretty much any areas where you want to look a little bit more bronzy, where you want to, you know, chisel everything out. I'm going to quickly finish the eyes. I'm taking a black eyeliner, and I'm just going to apply that to my waterline. I'm going back in with the pencil brush and the eggplant shade one more time, and I'm just going to apply that to the lower lashes. And then I'm taking the brush that I use to apply the fiery red shades, and I'm just going to use whatever is left on that brush and just smoke out the lower lash line using those colors. I'm going to go ahead and apply some mascara to my top and bottom lashes. I'm going to go ahead and apply a little bit of blush. This one is the Pixie Beauty Rome Rose Blush powder. It's kind of like a blush slash highlight because it does have a really nice pretty gold sheen to it. So I'm just going to apply that to the apples of the cheeks. I also went ahead and applied some lashes. I don't know the style of these lashes because I lost the box. Like, I just had them sitting around in my room, but I will try to find them and link them down below. So moving on to lips, I am taking the Lipland Reezy liquid lipstick. It has been forever since I used this shade, and I forgot how much I loved this color. It's like the perfect nudie peachy shade. And then to top off the lips, I'm taking the Marc Jacobs sugar lip gloss. This was the perfect gloss for this particular lipstick because it just kind of made it a little bit more neutral, more pinky, and it just looked so beautiful. So once you have done that, I'm just going to go ahead and take my e.l.f. setting spray and just set the makeup, and that's it, you guys. The look is completed. I promise to continue to work on this technique, so maybe you'll see it again soon a little bit better. And that's it. I love you. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please don't forget to subscribe before you go, and I'll see you soon. Bye.